This is a First Choice Superchannel feature presentation. Rated PG by Primetime Magazine. The following program deals with mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
I see a new world. Can you see it? The poor are no longer hungry. The rich cannot hoard their wealth. Everyone has enough to live well. This is a birthright. Wealth is not power, and true power does not serve wealth. People are devoted to actions they love. Our work is our passion, and our passion is our task.
Hey, the real world isn't like that. That's a lot of nonsense. You should go out there and take a look. What are you doing? You better not take that. You can hurt yourself. You want to go back into that coma?
Musician escapes from hospital, and the Wizards win big. Colder today, but clear. I'm Christy Hines for the National Television Network. Details at 8.
This is Answer, the alternate news service. Good morning. I'm Sophia Summers. The program is NewsScope. Here are the stories we'll be looking at in the next several hours. Declining corporate profits have been blamed on foreign competition, poor productivity, and government interference. But little attention is given to management itself. Are managers sacrificing long-term corporate health for short-term dividends and temporary profits? In the last 10 years, the number of lawyers has tripled. Are our rights being better protected by all this increased litigation? Violent crimes are rising yearly. How can the police control those who are so completely blind to the humanity of others? We have more doctors now than ever before, yet our good health is far from assured. Is the biomedical viewpoint preventing doctors from understanding the true nature of illness? Government and critics' comprehension of the arts is decreasing. Can art survive without an appreciative culture and an insightful criticism to sustain it? More people are graduating from college now than ever before, but our ability to understand the modern world has diminished. Have we failed to provide the kind of education we really need? The energy industry is too little concerned with the energy costs of producing energy. Should scarce research funds be devoted to developing more cost-efficient processes? Automation threatens everyone's livelihood, yet people cannot conceive of life without jobs. How will we adjust when only 30% of the people are needed to work and 70% remain idle, restless, and poverty-stricken? In a moment, our first story.
The city is a symphony of voices. Several symphonies played at once, in different keys, at different tempos. Each voice responds to the others. Each movement builds on previous ones. Harmony emerges slowly. To understand the city, you have to learn to listen.
Demonstrators gather today at the Sun Nuclear Power Plant to protest alleged safety code violations. Janet Hughes, leader of the local Nuclear Watch Alliance, spoke for the protesters.
We got suspicious when Commonwealth closed down the tours of the high school students that they used to have in the containment plant. And then we saw the photographs that show the cracks in the concrete foundations, and they're very deep. And the radioactivity in that plant is at a dangerous level right now. It's really dangerous, and we're all around here, we're all really scared, because we want that plant closed down and we want Sun cleaned up.
Later today, the fourth quarter profit reports will be revealed by the city's major corporations. According to most experts, the local economy is rebounding well from the recent slump. The only question mark is the Lambda Corporation, hard hit by foreign competition. Lambda employs 25% of the workforce in this city. Indicators suggest that 12 of Lambda's 20 divisions are now profitable. But the fate of our 8 local divisions remains uncertain. Lambda President Preston Sturrock meets with the board of directors today. He will unveil a plan to make the company profitable by the first quarter of next year. In the past few weeks, Lambda stock has been quite volatile. Protests of his era. Hubar's music was best known for its ability to fuse many distinctive styles. Hubar awoke from his coma last month, only days before doctors were going to turn off his costly life support system. Now coming up, sports with Don Johnson.
Lambda will close its 8 unprofitable divisions. Not sell, close down completely. The losses this quarter will make next year look profitable. Lambda stock will plummet. Workers will lose their jobs permanently. We must play on their fears, their fantasies, their confusions. Some will try and run. We'll offer them inflated real estate deals. White, make the purchases and evict the current tenants.
Yes, sir.
Green, encourage those who remain to buy stock to save their jobs. Buy low, have the workers increase its value, sell high. Others will rely on hope. We'll offer them insurance, high cost, unemployment insurance, to protect them when their benefits expire. Add an escape clause. Our profits will be one-third of their benefits. Write the policies, prepare the ads, and mingle.
Do we try to induce greater fear, boss?
In every possible way.
Don't even bother. Arte never has time.
So how's it going?
Not bad.
Got all your tracks synced up?
No, I've just got the rhythm tracks worked out.